Hi, NHRA fans. Lewis Plume once again in our new Wally Parks Studio in downtown California. I am joined on Skype by the six-time NHRA champion, six, five in Pro Stock, once in Supergas, Jeg Coughlin Jr. Hi, Jeg.
Hello. How are we doing?
I'm hanging in there. So it looks like you're at the office. So you guys are actually working. I bet people are buying parts because they can work in their garage by themselves and work on their hot rods, right?
Well, definitely looks that way. You know, we've got our hands full as a nation and as a world right now, and certainly our hearts out to all involved. But yes, right now things in Ohio, our governor has been very aggressive, erring on the cautious side. And but as of now, things are still 100% a go, and you know we're here for our customers, but. First and foremost, we're here for all of our associates and want to have a good, safe work environment. And, you know, we'd like for all this just to kind of transition past as quickly and as efficiently as we can so we can, get back to the day-to-day life as we've known it in our lifetime.
So I would assume JEGS is big enough that there's a human resource department that is making sure everybody stays safe, right?
Absolutely. Yeah, that's been our number one goal here for the last couple of weeks. As things have just continued to develop, really by a minutely basis. So, we've got a good crew here, fortunately, and we're taking all the known precautions that we can to keep our workplace safe and in turn, hoping that all of our associates stay well and healthy.
Well, of course, when we talk to Jeg, we want to talk about drag racing. You're the last guy to win a Pro Stock race because you won the World Door Slammer Nationals in Orlando, paying $75,000. And I love the photo of your daughter on top of the car holding some of the cash. I mean, you're spoiling her.
Well, yeah, that was maybe an oversight on Dad's part there. That wasn't quite the plan, but we had such a great time at the event. Richard Freeman, my team owner, car owner, he and Drag Illustrated with Wes Buck, decided about 2 months ago to put a race together that would feature Pro Stock and Pro Modified as the marquee of the event, and picked a great weekend to do it, a week before the Gator Nationals. And we had a great turnout on the Pro Stock side and, of course, on Pro Mod as well. And Orlando did a really nice job hosting us all. On top of that, we had probably another six classes or so running, and there was always a lot of great action on the track, and in our case, 2 days later, 3 days later, to come away with that, armful of cash, as our Cold Heart Art Trophy has $75,000 included right in the middle of the trophy. It's very, very cool, and it was an honor to win the inaugural event. My guess is we'll see a second annual.
Maybe you'll come out of retirement for that one to be the defending champion. You know, think about that. One race, come down to Florida. Yeah, I believe you have property there, so wouldn't be much of a stretch, right?
No, I could probably be twisted to participate in that. And in fact, Richard and I have already kidded about it. Hopefully he'll keep my seat insert that fits one of the current cars for next year. potentially we can slide right in, maybe play Pro Stock driver again.
Well, speaking of your current car, have you ever had a car that is this good racing in Pro Stock? I mean, you've had good cars over the year. You don't win five championships without a good car. But this particular car, the way this car is running, the performances, dominating at Pomona, getting every point possible. What's it like to have a car that is this good?
I can tell you it's felt fantastic. Ricky Jones, we elected to go back into our Rick Jones built car for Pomona, and made 23 test runs on the car down in Bradenton before going out to Pomona for the Winter Nationals, the famed 60th Winter Nationals. I made three of those 23 runs, and my nephew Troy Jr. made 20 of them, so much credit to him from behind the wheel, quite honestly, and also Ricky and the entire team. They've really worked hard to get the balance right on the car. And then naturally, as we got closer to Pomona, Jake Harrison and Richard and everyone at Elite Performance then had some new gadgetry for us to run under the hood. And we enjoyed kind of getting that to set seat in over the first couple of runs at Pomona, and by the time we left there, we were flying. Felt great.
Some new gadgets. You can't share what they are, right? I don't believe you're allowed to talk about that, right?
Listen, let me tell you a secret here. Just between you and I, right? No, it's the guys have been working really hard. We've got some great partners under the hood with Carl Foltz, namely being one of them. He's been energized and working extremely hard on our behalf. And he had some new things that we were testing, quite honestly. And it looks like a little bit of that was going in the right direction, and we're still refining on it. So I think 2020 is going to be a fun year for us. It's definitely going to be a fun year regardless. But naturally, we're having the most fun when we're doing well. And far in the first three races of the year, two NHRA races and the World Door Slammer Nationals, we've won all three of them between Erica and myself. So life is good at Team Elite right now.
You mentioned your nephew, Troy Coughlin Jr. He looked really good. I watched a lot of videos from the race. I've watched him testing in pro stock. He looks like a natural in the race car. What do you think of his future in the class?
He's probably made more runs outside of a pro stock car than anyone I know. Trust me. Growing up, the son to Troy, my second oldest brother, who had been racing pro stock since 1994, TJ was four at the time. And trust me, at age four to today, he still makes the same pro stock sounds he did at age four. They're just a little more defined. And I got to admit, I was right there next to him. That's how I grew up. I've run a lot of these different races and race cars in my head many, many times before I ever was able to even get in one. So I think that's a big contributing factor to our comfort, maybe early on as it looks. But Troy's made a lot of runs in a simulator that I designed in 1996. I was getting ready to go into Competition Eliminator, and I've driven a stick car on the street, but never had driven a Liberty style or a stick on the drag strip. And my good friend Ted Gregorius with a tag out of New York, did some masterful work. I sent him, I think I faxed, yes, I did fax it. This was 1997, five laid out paper towels of drawings on how you could build this pro stock simulator with the Christmas tree to simulate the Christmas tree start, and then simulate and measure each and every one of the four gear changes and give you a reaction on each one. So I've had that since then, and Troy Jr. has probably made as many runs on that as I have. So long-windedly, we've made a lot of runs together. And when he made his first runs in Bradenton before I had to peel out of there, he looked very comfortable. And over the course of the next 3 days, did very well. And then you fast forward to the opportunity had, thanks to Richard Freeman, to hop behind the Elite Motorsports Chevy Camaro that Bob Benzel was getting ready to race at the Gator Nationals to make some shakedown runs in that and make sure it was all set for Bob to compete there. He did a great job, getting by three-time world champ and teammate to Erica and Enders in the first round. And then, lo and behold, if I'm not looking across the way to see him in the other lane from me, second round. And trust me, I knew what he was capable of. I knew what his car was capable of. And this guy was definitely on his best behavior. And we had one heck of a drag race. I turned out in my favor. And then naturally the next two rounds did as well. So bright future for him, regardless of what he's driving. Even if he hops back in the top fuel car, I've got no issues him going A to B and setting the world on fire. So just have to wait and see.
You sound like a very proud uncle, no doubt about it. Now, you decided to retire. Jason Lyne decided to retire, to step away from driving. To have two, major players of the class to step away. But, what ultimately is your decision about? Is it about spending time with family, just taking a break? I mean, you've kind of retired a couple times before, but have always come back. What's different this time?
Well, I've never really officially retired before. So I've stepped away, taken maybe a gap year here and there for just different reasons. But I'm excited. I've been racing pro stock nearly half of my adult life. So that's quite a long time, almost 23 years. So I've had, great runs. I've had great teams. I've had great race wins, championships, et cetera. And when I came back to race with Richard Freeman in 2016, I really was planning to run 1 year. It was never announced that way. And then potentially transition the wheel over going into 2017. That didn't quite pan out that way. And we ended up making some changes within the team. And I stuck around from behind the wheel. And I've really had a great time. And that's been probably the biggest reason I've stuck around. That will be the hardest reason for me to slide out. But there's a good chance I'll still have my my hand in at some level. And that would be gratifying and enough for me to be able to maybe attend a few races. I've never ruled out driving another race. Maybe, like you said earlier in the show, maybe I will get back behind the wheel. But I really am looking more toward an elective schedule. As most of the viewers know, and as you know, bracket racing has been my first love and still is. And I'd like to get some more of those events as well as many other events. So not a shortness of racing available. As I sit here in our Delaware, Ohio headquarters at Jegs, we've got a lot of work to do here as a 60-year company. We need to continue to poise and put it in a position for another 60. So I enjoy my work, I enjoy my racing, and I certainly enjoy my family. So a lot of great things in my future.
I think you got things in perspective, Jeg. Before we go, any chance we'll see you race a sportsman class this year? I know you got some race cars at the shop that are, pretty impressive. Super Comp, Top Dragster, Super Gas. I love your wagon. Your wagon's one of my favorite cars of all time, like Super Street.
Mine too.
Are we going to see that, one of those cars with you driving later this year, maybe?
There's a real good chance of it, for sure. At what events at this point, I'm not sure. I'm definitely going to hit a couple of the big money bracket races this year, the SFG 500 in Valdosta, Georgia, providing things go off well there in about 6 weeks, and then the $1.1 million to win SFG in Martin, Michigan, which I had real good success there last year at the 500. So, and then I'm hoping to get a spring fling event in as well, and maybe just tiptoe if one of my brothers or my wife will let me, maybe one of the sportsman cards at an NHRA national race. So I definitely enjoy my seat time, and when I get the chance, I try and take advantage of it.
Well, Jeg, you're a class act, great champion, and my favorite Bob Fry stat, Bob Fry pretty much is the master, is that you are the only driver in NHRA history to win from number one through number 16. All 16 qualified spots, you won Indy from the bump spot. You're the only one. That stat still blows my mind. So that's kind of a fun part of your resume, Jeg. I know you love that.
Yeah, honestly, it blows my mind too. And I would have never known that fact without Bob's assistance. So it is cool. The numbers are what they are. We approach every race, whether we're number one or number 16, to win the race. And fortunately, we've been able to do that from each spot, as you mentioned. But, certainly just thinking of the world here and thinking of all of our friends and fans out there, to want you to stay well and stay healthy and look forward to seeing you down the road.
Hey, Jeg, thanks for taking the time. I agree with your sentiments 100%. Stay safe. And hopefully we'll see you at a racetrack sometime in the near future. And thanks for joining us.
Sounds great. Thank you all.
Jeg Coughlin, 5-time Pro Stock champion, Super Gas champion, class act all the way from Jegs in Delaware, Ohio. Thanks for watching. Don't forget NHRA.tv with more content every day, NHRA.com, and all our social channels, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, YouTube. You know them all. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.